on behalf of the families and students in New York State. I think we're all trying to get our arms around the cost of this potential program. And so to know how many students actually carry 15 credits, how many actually graduate in 4 years is certainly going to be helpful to that end. With that in mind, SUNY is governed by a board that, at least in theory, is separate and apart from the governor's office. But that being said, there are some major policy changes being proposed in the governor's executive budget with regard to SUNY. For example, I would like to ask you if you support the governor's proposal to extend free tuition to undocumented immigrants.
Yes.
Okay. I agree with you in terms of your opening remarks with regard to your statement on economic impact. I come from a region that has 8 private colleges, 2 SUNYs, and a couple of community colleges, but 2 privates within my district. And so here we have some proposals that, in my judgment, hurt our independent colleges, like St. John Fisher and Nazareth College. We are, on one hand, limiting their ability to increase their tuition by more than $500, yet for them to lose their Bundy and TAP funding. Do you think it's fair that you can increase tuition at the SUNY level, but at the same time, the governor is directly attacking the ability of your competitors to do the same thing?
Well, I only know that SUNY is incredibly affordable, and we've tried to live within the plateaus that the governor and the state have provided for us, all the way back to rational tuition. So I don't think I'm in the position to comment on issues between public and private, but I do think my obligation as a leader of a public institution is to keep our costs down and keep our tuition down.
One other question. Being from Rochester, I'm very concerned about recent events that would seem to spell trouble for our photonics initiative. SUNY Poly is, at least in theory, under the SUNY banner. What oversight do you have there?
Start. What oversight do we have over SUNY Poly?
Yes.
Total oversight. They are one of our 64 campuses, and our expectation is that the leadership and operation of that campus will be on par with every other one of our campuses. As you know, when trouble arose, we took immediate action to change the leadership of the SUNY Poly campus. We now have an outstanding researcher, administrator, leading SUNY Poly in Professor Bhagat Samakia. He's outstanding. He is getting, every day, getting that institution back on track to be the polytechnic institute we know it can become.
So at this point, you believe you're taking, you're doing everything you can to ensure the success of the photonics project?
Well, within the SUNY Poly portfolio is photonics. I will say that our provost, Alex Cartwright, is a photonics specialist and is keeping a personal eye on the growth of the photonics program. And if he were here today instead of at the Board of Trustees meeting, I'd ask him to elaborate. I might not understand what he's saying, but I know he's on it.
All right. Chancellor, thank you.
Thank you.